Okay, strawberry cocktails. Why am I not doing this right before Valentine's Day? Or why am I not doing it in the summer? It's because strawberries are awesome. You can have them any time of year, and they are completely underutilized in cocktails, in my opinion. So today we're doing strawberry cocktails three ways, starting with a basic version all the way up to the more advanced chemist version. All right, so for our basic version, the easiest way to incorporate fresh strawberries into a cocktail is just to muddle them into a basic sour. So here we're adding 3/4 of an ounce or 22 mils of simple syrup and about 2 strawberries, and we're just gonna muddle it all together into a shaker glass. We're gonna balance that with about 3/4 of an ounce or 22 mils of fresh lime juice. And for our base spirit, we're gonna go with gin because it pairs really well with most fruit, but you could also do tequila, white rum, vodka. Most light colored spirits work well here. So 2 ounces or 60 mils. Then we're gonna shake that vigorously with ice for about 15 seconds, which will also extract some more of the strawberry juices. Now, strawberries will vary a lot in their sweetness and acidity. So at this point, it'd be a good idea just to give a quick taste and see if it needs a little more sugar or a little more lime juice just to balance it out. These berries were a bit on the tart side, so we're just gonna add a touch more simple and give that another quick shake. Then we're gonna wanna double strain this into a chilled coupe glass, and because there's gonna be a good amount of strawberry pulp, you might need to roll it around in the mesh strainer to get it all out. Garnish that with a little cheeky strawberry, and let's give this a taste, our basic strawberry sour. All right, that is super refreshing. I mean, the strawberry is the star of the show, pairs super well with the gin, and sometimes when you're trying to showcase a specialty ingredient, just keeping it really simple is the best way to go. Highly recommend this one. All right, let's step it up for our pro version of a strawberry cocktail, which is gonna revolve around this magical strawberry-infused Campari. So here we're combining 4 or 5 chopped up strawberries, which was about 300 grams, with about 10 ounces or 300 mils of Campari. You don't have to be too precise here, but we're just gonna seal that, store it in the fridge for about 5 days or so, give it a shake every day and taste it until it has enough strawberry flavor. Now we're gonna strain this into some kind of sealable vessel to store in the fridge. I always like using this one here, even though I know it's gonna be too small. I keep hoping otherwise. Sure enough, too small. But the show must go on. I mean, look at it with its big old cork. I call it Corky McCorkface. Okay, now I'm just stalling. This'll store in the fridge for at least a month. Grab Mr. McCorkface and we're gonna make a strawberry Negroni. So start with 1 ounce or 30 mils of our strawberry infused Campari, then 1 ounce or 30 mils of sweet vermouth, then 1 ounce or 30 mils of a dry gin. Then we're gonna add ice and stir for about 30 to 45 seconds. Now you could infuse the strawberries into the gin instead of the Campari, but I like doing the Campari in case I wanna switch up my Negroni and make it like a mezcal Negroni or do a strawberry Campari and soda, but that's your call. All right, grab yourself a rocks glass and a big old clear ice block. Then once you let that ice temper to prevent cracking when you pour the cocktail over it, we're going to just strain our strawberry Negroni over the top. And what I love about these clear ice blocks is that when you place a garnish, like a little strawberry here on top, it looks like it's just floating on top of the cocktail. All right, let's give it a go, our strawberry Negroni. And honestly, this is like one of my favorite cocktails ever. It's a little bitter, sweet, tart all at the same time. It just adds a little brightness to this classic. I love this. All right, cocktail number 3, the chemist version. You know things are gonna get wild when I reach for my Bible, Dave Arnold's Liquid Intelligence. In the book, he talks about this glorious strawberry cube and a new way to introduce juice into your cocktails. So to make these, you're gonna wanna cut the stems off some strawberries and it'll be about 35 grams of strawberry for every cube you wanna make. Throw them into a blender and puree them. You certainly don't need a Vitamix, but this jet engine of a blender sure does help. Now we're gonna try to strain out some of the solids here through either a fine mesh sieve, a nut milk bag like this, no comments please, or a cheesecloth. If you're working through some issues, you can roleplay your favorite murder scene as you strain out all of that strawberry juice, ideally into a bigger container than this. And so once the deed is done, we're gonna measure out 1 ounce or 30 mils of this puree into an ice cube tray and freeze it overnight. All right, let's make a drink with this. So we're gonna add 2 of these strawberry cubes into a shaker glass. So that's 2 ounces of frozen strawberry puree, and then 2 ounces or 60 mils of tequila. I'm gonna do 1/4 ounce or about 7 mils of strained fresh lime juice, and then 1/2 ounce or 15 mils of simple syrup. Then we're gonna add a pinch of salt to brighten that up. We're not gonna add any ice here. We're gonna do what Dave Arnold calls the juice shake. The problem we're trying to solve with this method is that if you use room temperature strawberry puree and then add ice to chill and dilute it, it's just gonna be over-diluted because there's so much water in strawberry juice. So by shaking to completion, meaning the strawberry cubes are fully melted, you get the right amount of dilution and chilling for this drink. So then we're just gonna free pour into a chilled coupe glass. And my God, that looks pretty. So let's give this a taste, our Chemist's Strawberry Cocktail. Okay, wow, that is like a strawberry bomb, and it's amazing with that tequila. It's actually a pretty thick texture with that puree, but it's delicious. If you clarified the strawberry juice, you'd probably get some of that intense flavor, but a little thinner. But you gotta try this technique, it's wild. And a big thank you to House for sponsoring this video. House makes some of my favorite aperitifs. Their product is all natural and it shows. It's made with real fruits, herbs, botanicals, and they blend, bottle, and ship it all to you straight from Sonoma County. It's a testament to how good this stuff is. They sent me a couple bottles to try and I finished them before I even got a chance to film this video. Sorry guys. But I was more than happy to go out and buy some more to try out some new flavors, including this delicious ginger yuzu aperitif. It's got yuzu, ginger root, lemongrass, and it's super aromatic and zesty and just the right amount of kick from that ginger. It's excellent. I've almost gone through these guys' entire catalog at this point, but I'm really keen to try this rose rosé flavor, especially if you're into strawberry. It looks excellent, but honestly, there's something for everyone. The bitter clove is another one I really like. It's made with the Amaro and whiskey lover in mind. It has a really predominantly herbal flavor to it. You guys seriously need to try this stuff, and right now you can get 15% off your order when you use my code CHEMISTRY2 and click the link in the description box below. Thanks for watching, y'all. If you like these three ways series of videos where I do a basic pro and chemist version of a cocktail, I've got a bunch more here and I'll put a few links on screen. Cheers.